Hey, everybody, you are listening and watching the We Are Rising podcast. This is your host, Andrew Benjamin, and I'm joined by a very special guest with us. We got Nadaka Yoshinari, who will be taking on Fet Molly in a kickboxing match at Rising 26 at the Saitama Super Arena. Nadaka is also known as Nadaka Ewa Sports Gym. Yoshinari-san, thank you very much for talking to us for this interview. Yoroshiku onegaishimasu. My first question is for you is, I want to know, how you got into kickboxing. Can you just tell us how you started in kickboxing?
はい、吉野選手、本日はお忙しい中ご出演していただき誠にありがとうございます。
はい。
まず格闘技を始めたきっかけについて教えていただけますか？
はい、格闘技は、4歳の時から始めたんですけど、最初空手で、空手を4歳の時から始めました。
Hi. Oh, so Andrew, Yoshinari-san says I started Kakutogi when I was 4 years old. So he started in karate originally.
Okay. How did you, or when did you decide that you wanted to go into kickboxing?
いつ頃の時期から空手からキックボクシングに移ろうと思いましたか？
空手からキックボクシングに移ったのは10歳の時で、小学校4年生の時だったんですけど、自分の体格だと空手だとなかなか試合で勝てなかったので、キックボクシングの方が自分のルールに合ってるかなと思ったので、4年生の時にキックボクシングに転向しました。
はい。So Yoshinari-san says, when I was around 10 years old, so this is when I was about grade 4, I made the change to kickboxing. This is mainly due to my size. I couldn't really win in many matches in karate, so he thought that kickboxing was better for him.
I see. And what about, so you, not only do you do kickboxing, but you mainly are known for Muay Thai, being a Lumpini Stadium champion. Can you tell us when you decided that you wanted to do Muay Thai kickboxing specifically?
吉野選手はキックボクシングでも活躍されていますが、主にムエタイ選手として有名だと思うんですが、いつ頃からそのムエタイに移行しようと思いましたか？
ムエタイの初めて試合をしたのが小学校6年生の時なんですけど、12歳の時で、その時にムエタイの選手に試合やって負けてしまって、その時にこう自分もムエタイでトップに立ちたいなと思ったので、12歳からムエタイの練習を始めました。
はい。So, Yoshinari-san says, grade 6 was the first time that I competed in a Muay Thai match, but unfortunately, I lost in that match, but he wanted to continue to get better at it. So when he was around 12 years old, he started to do Muay Thai quite exclusively.
I see. Actually, I'm curious to know, since you started so young, what did your parents think, your Oda-san and Oka-san, what did they think about you going to such a, I guess, physical sport?
Sure. その6年生というとても幼い時期からムエタイとか格闘技を始められていると思うんですが、それについて、はい、吉内選手のご両親はどのようにふうに思われていましたか？
まあ、中学校の勉強だったりもあったんですけど、自分はもうムエタイで一番になりたいっていうふうに思ってたので、その目標をずっと両親は応援してくれてました。
So Yoshinari-san says, there are aspects like study that, of course, come into question, but his goal was to become the number one Muay Thai fighter, and his parents were, absolutely supportive of that decision, and yeah.
Oh, that's good to hear. That's good to hear. So I guess one of the big questions I have is what is it like competing in kickboxing in Japan versus Thailand? Can you just tell us what the atmosphere is and how do you have a preference for one specific, audience?
So you mean as well, like the difference in the kickboxing rules and the Muay Thai rules as well?
Yeah, but just like, what atmosphere does he enjoy most competing in front of?
Yeah, sure.
You know, with Muay Thai, you got the music, you got it's a lot more, louder. And, you know, kickboxing in Japan, the audience is a lot more reserved type thing.
Sure. あの日本であのそのキックボクシングの試合に出るのとあのタイであの試合するのと雰囲気とかがすごくあの異なると思うんですが、あの、はい、それについてどういかがでしょうか。どっちの方がその雰囲気があの好きとかそういうのあるんでしょうか。
自分はあのずっとここ 3,4 年ぐらいずっとタイ人との試合が続いていて、で今年に入って日本人と試合したのは本当4年ぶりぐらいで、でやっぱり雰囲気は全然違うなと思うんですけど、自分的にはこうあのタイの本場のタイのあのラジャダムランスタジアムとかの試合の雰囲気がすごい好きです。
はい。So Yoshinari-san explains that for the last 3 years he's been fighting predominantly with Thai fighters, and the last time that he fought a Japanese fighter was actually the first time in 4 years, so that was quite a change. But generally speaking, he prefers the atmosphere fighting in the Thai stadiums.
Is there any particular reason why?
So the Thai でのスタジアムであの戦う方を選んだ理由は何でしょうか？
そのタイでやるってなると、試合するってなるとやっぱり本場のスタジアムはやっぱラジャダムランとルンピニーなので、そこで試合してかつ選手がムエタイの中だと本物だと思うので、それを目指して頑張りました。はい。
はい。So Andrew Yoshinari-san explains that because you know the main ground of Muay Thai is in Lumpini and Rajamnan Stadium, so because he's sort of aiming to be the sort of best in Muay Thai, like fighting in that sort of home base is more important to him.
I see. I'm curious to know what do you think about when these Thai fighters who you go up against, when you see their record and they have like 100 fights or like over 100 fights on their record, what do you think about that when you see that? Is that intimidating, or you don't even think about that? It's just a number to you.
あのタイの選手はあのその幼い頃からあのアマチュアとかで結構活躍されていて、その100戦以上経験されている選手とかもいると思うんですけど、はい、そういう選手と対戦した時あのどういうふうに思われていますか？そのレコードに関してはただの数字というふうにあの見られていますか？
そうですね、やっぱりあのムエタイの選手はあの経験値が本当にすごいので、試合の数も自分と全然違うんですけど、でもあの練習量では自分の方があると思ってるので、そこはあんまり試合の時は気にしてないです。
はい。 So Yoshinari-san says you know, it is quite daunting to see the sort of huge careers of these Thai fighters, but he thinks that he's got that advantage in terms of the amount of training he's done, so that doesn't really affect him when he's facing these Thai fighters.
Gotcha. Let us talk about Ryzen for a second. I do want to just ask him, talk about Ryzen 22, his fight against Yushin. And it was the first fight in Ryzen history, kickboxing, to allow elbows. I'm just curious to know, was that something that Ryzen asked his team or to Yoshinari-san? Or was that something that Yoshinari-san's team requested? I'm curious to know about that, why the elbows rules was allowed for his match for the first time.
Sure. あの、Ryzen 22で、あの、Yushin、あの、選手との、あの、対戦が、あの、その、Ryzen 史上初の、あの、肘ありキックボクシングルールだったと思うんですが、そのルールに関しては、あの、Ryzen の方から、あの、持ってこられた提案でしたか？それとも、あの、Yoshinari選手のチームの方からの提案でしたでしょうか？
多分そのオファーいただいたときはあの多分キックボクシングルールだったと思うんですけど、なんで多分メータイルールその肘ありの方が自分の持ち味が生きると思ったので、多分ジムの方からそういうふうにお願いしたんだと思います。
はい。So Andrew, he says that when Ryzen originally brought the offer, he thinks that they gave him a regular sort of kickboxing match, but on his side they requested that elbows be allowed because that shows better Yoshinari-san sort of, you know, true skills.
Gotcha. And I just want to talk about that fight. One more thing is just how he won that fight. And one of the things that was significant in that fight was those takedowns, those trips, Muay Thai trips that he was doing to Yushin, and that just took all the energy out of Yushin. Is that something that he regularly trains in, just tripping his opponent and just throwing them down just to take all their energy out and just make it harder for them to continue on as the fight goes?
Yep, sure. あの前回のそのユーシン選手とであの圧倒的なあの強さをあの見せたあの吉成選手ですが、あの特にあの印象的だったのがそのムエタイ特有のその転がせるようなユーシン選手のこう、はい、あのそれは普段からあの強化されている技なんでしょうか？
そうですね、ムエタイでは首相撲は本当に基本の技なので、それをやっぱり練習から普段毎日やってるので、そこの技術、ムエタイの技術がその試合で生きたのかなと思います。
はい。So Andrew, he says that's a pretty basic sort of foundation move in Muay Thai, so he does practice it every day, and he thought I guess he was able to make that to good use in his recent Ryzen match.
Mm-hmm. And let's talk about his Ryzen 26 match against Pet Molly, New Year's Eve, Saitama Super Arena. Just curious to know what are his thoughts on his opponent, if he's done any research. Before that, does he research his opponents before he has a fight, or does he go in there blank slate?
Sure. Yoshinari 選手はその対戦相手のなんていうんですか、その分析とかリサーチはあの結構する方ですか？
そうですね、対戦相手の試合の動画を結構見ることはあります。はい。
He says, yes, he does tend to research his opponents. He watches their videos, whatever that's available.
Gotcha. So with Pet Molly, has he done a research on Pet Molly so far? He's had a ton of fights. You can find them on YouTube. So, has he done the same thing for his upcoming opponent at Ryzen 26?
Yep, sure. 今回、Ryzen 26 で対戦相手のペットマライ選手に関しても、その分析はされましたでしょうか？そしてどういう印象をお持ちでしょうか？
はい、もちろん動画見て分析というか対策はしてるんですけど、相手の印象はパンチでどんどん前に来て、あとはそのムエタイの首相撲を使ってどんどん崩してくる選手なので、まあ、それをうまく攻撃かわしながら自分の攻撃を当てていきたいなと思ってます。
はい。Yoshinari-san says, yes, of course I have watched a lot of his videos that's available. In terms of what he thinks of Pet Malai, he's got the impression that he tends to go forward, sort of closes the distance quite well. His clinches are also pretty impressive, but he intends to sort of, you know, not back down from that and then just, you know, keep going and then get his strikes in.
When you're training for a fight, do you train differently if it's a Muay Thai fighter versus, say, another Japanese fighter? Is that taken into consideration?
その日本人の選手と戦うときと、タイ人の選手と戦うときと、何かトレーニングを変えたりすることはありますか？
トレーニングを変えたりとかはしないんですけど、やっぱりタイ人の選手とやるときは、タイ人の選手が首相撲が強いので、そこを気をつけるようにしてます、いつも。
はい。He says nothing sort of dramatically changes in sort of his usual training, but he does note that Thai fighters are very good with their clinches, so he'll be very careful of that.
Mm-hmm. And so for this fight, how does it feel? You fought on the Ryzen Return Show. Now you're fighting on Ryzen's final show. How does it feel to to be on their big final show in New Year's Eve at the Saitama Super Arena?
前回その Ryzen 22 のカムバックショーで初参戦して、そしてされて、そして今回その年末の大きなRyzen を締めくく、今年を締めくくRyzenの大会にまた参戦することになりましたが、それについてはいかがでしょうか？
はい、8月に出場した大会に続いて、今回こういう 大晦日っていうみんなが見てる大会に出れることが本当に嬉しい気持ちでいっぱいです。
はい。So following his appearance at you know, Ryzen 22, he's very happy to have been, you know, brought on again to this, you know, big New Year's Eve show, and he's just full of gratitude and happiness, really.
And so what? I know that, I don't know if he wants to talk strategy about the fight, but is there anything that he can tell us in terms of how he sees a fight going in his favor, how he predicts he'll dictate the pace or finish?
Sure. その今回そのペットマライ選手に関してどういうふうな試合の展開を予想されていますか。その多分難しいと思うんですが、答えられる範囲でお願いいたします。
はい、まあ、ペットマライ選手もタイでベルトを持っている強い選手なので、ムエタイらしいリズムの試合になると思うんですけど、でもそのリズムだけじゃなくて、自分は出入りとかを早くして、こうスピーディーな試合にしたいと思っているので、で、最終的には自分が KO で倒すっていうビジョンを今頭で浮かべてます。
はい。So he says his opponent, you know, has a belt in Thailand. He thinks that the rhythm will be very much in sort of Muay Thai pace, but Yoshinari-san plans to, you know, go in and out, make it really speedy, and ultimately he envisions him knocking out his opponent.
And actually, speaking of more about Ryzen, I do want to take our first listener question from Oliver Green at magic_mark787, and he wants to know, does Yoshinari-san plan on staying in Ryzen, and what are his goals in the organization?
Sure, and I think Oliver also had a comment for Yoshinari-san.
Oh yes, yes.
So I can.
It is a question, but he loved his last fight. He hopes he stays in Ryzen and puts on awesome fights like he did the last time.
Yep. Okay. 本日第1問目 のファンから のご質問に、なります、オリバー・グリーンさんです。吉成選手はこれからもライジンという舞台で戦える予定でしょうか。今後の展望は何でしょうか。前回ライジン22での吉成選手の試合は最高でした。これからも吉成選手の素晴らしい試合をライジンで見れることを楽しみにしております。
そうですね、ライジンは来年以降も自分は出場したいと思っていて、ライジンに出ることによって自分がムエタイの象徴として、これからどんどんムエタイをライジンで広めていきたいなと思ってます。
はい。 So Yoshinari-san's response is yes, he does plan to fight in Ryzen next year too. He also thinks that by fighting in Ryzen, he also be able to, you know, spread Muay Thai in Japan as, you know, sort of the symbol of, you know, the sort of Japanese Muay Thai fighter.
And actually, that's a great segue into our second fan question from our boy Apparatus Lattice. He wants to know, since Muay Thai rules events are not as common in Japan as kickboxing, does he feel any extra pressure in Ryzen compared to fighting on shows like Bomb, Battle of Muay, from being seen as a guy who could bring it to the masses? I think he kind of answered that a little bit at the end. But if he wants to expand upon that, he's more than welcome to.
Yep, sure. こちらアパラータス、ユーザーネーム、ハンドネームアパラータスさんからの、ご質問になります。やはりそのキックボクシングと比べるとムエタイルールでの試合の開催は日本で少ないと思うんですが、その中ムエタイの看板選手としてライジンで活躍されることについてどう思えていますか。ボムの大会などに出場されている時と比べるとやはりライジンでのプレッシャーの方が大きく感じられますか。
はい、そうですね、やっぱライジンはムエタイのムエタイをこう詳しく知ってる人があまりいないと思うので、そこでやっぱり自分がムエタイっていうのを分かりやすい試合をしなきゃいけないっていうやっぱプレッシャーは少しあります。はい、
はい。So he does think that Ryzen probably has more of an audience who aren't so knowledgeable about Muay ThaiTie. So he does feel the pressure in terms of putting on a Muay Thai fight that is sort of easily understood by viewers in the audience.
Mm-hmm. And so I'm curious, so going back to the Ryzen goals, does he want to, would he like to see maybe a tournament, Grand Prix in his weight division? Or how does he want, how would he like his career in Ryzen to go forward, if ideally?
Sure. そのライジンでこれから活躍することにして、あのその吉成選手は例えばそのあの肘ありキックボクシングルールでのトーナメントなど、そういうものなんていうんですかね、そういうものを期待していますか？
まあその肘ありルールで、あの今の自分の階級だったら、あの肘ありルールだったら今結構自分はすごい強いっていう自信があるので、そういうトーナメントを開催してもらえるんだったら、自分の強さだったり、ムエタイの強さを証明できると思うので、あの、まあ、それは機会があるならば、ぜひ開催してほしいです。
はい。So, Andrea, I asked him actually if he wanted a tournament with, sort of with elbows. I didn't pose the question as a kickboxing rule, but he said yes, if there is the opportunity for Ryzen to have this tournament in his weight class with, elbows allowed, then he would, you know, absolutely love that opportunity. He's pretty confident that, you know, he's the strongest fighter in his division with, you know, with those kickboxing rules. So he'd love that opportunity.
Mm-hmm. I'm just curious to know, is it hard to find opponents? I'm guessing that's why he mostly fights in Taiwan, but in Japan, is it hard to find opponents in his weight class, especially now with COVID and country restrictions going in and out? Was it hard for Ryzen to find this opponent for him? I don't know if he happens to know that, but I'm curious to know if they told him, yeah, it was difficult to find an opponent in your weight class just because of... the restrictions that Japan has now for people coming in and out.
Yep, sure. So specifically for this fight, right?
Oh, yeah.
あの今回そのコロナウイルスで、あのその海外の選手をあの呼ぶこととかが、あの結構難しい状況だと思うのですが、今回のその試合の対戦相手、そのライジン側がそのあの吉成選手の対戦相手をあの見つけるのがあの難しいというふうにあのおっしゃっていたことはありますか？
そうですね。やっぱ日本人の選手だと、自分の階級だとあまり選手がいないので、やっぱやるとしたら海外の選手になるとは思ってたんですけど、こう、なんだろうな、タイの選手っていう一番こう、ムエタイを分かりやすいムエタイができるっていう選手をこう連れてきてくれたのは本当に感謝してます。
はい。He says, yes, it is difficult to find fighters in his division in Japan. So he thought that it would have had to be an overseas fighter that he's facing. But, you know, in the sort of difficult circumstance, he's very grateful that Ryzen has been able to bring him this opponent so that he could fight.
Mm-hmm. And continue on the topic of weight, I'm going to ask a question from our friend Luke from the UK. And he says that his question is, men's kickboxing in Japan has no major titles below 51 kilos. Is it his goal to move up to that weight and compete for them? Or does he want to stay in Muay Thai and defend titles at 49 kilograms?
Sure.あのこちらはあのイギリス在住のルークさんからのご質問になります。はい、日本ではその日本のキックボクシングでやはりあの51キロあたりのその、あの王者がキックボクシング王者がいない、あまりいないと思うんですが、あの吉成選手これから階級を上げてその日本のキックボクシング界であのその活躍されるそのなんていうんですかね、そのあのタイトルマッチなどにあの挑む予定はありますか？それともこれから主にその49キロであのムエタイ選手としてあの活躍される予定でしょうか？
そうですね。まだあの自分今19歳なんですけど、あの体重がまだ増えているので、来年再来年どんどん階級を上げていく予定なので、そこでまあ強い有名な選手とどんどんやっていけたらなと思ってます。
はい。Yoshinari-san says, I'm still 19 years old and my, you know, my weight is increasing. So I do plan to increase my weight class and continue to, you know, face various opponents.
Mm-hmm. I just want to also clarify, we did get a similar question from Fon KS through Fleet. So it was both a question from Luke and Fon KS. But actually, speaking of weight, where do you see yourself ideally...plateauing, or which weight class do you think you'll eventually settle at when you stop growing or stop gaining weight?
Sure. あの今吉成選手があのおっしゃったようにあのこれからその階級を上げていく予定ですがあの、はい、その どのくらいあたりの階級をあの目指されていますか？
今は53キロとか54キロバンタム級ぐらいを目指しています。
はい。So he says about 53 to 54 kilos, so that's probably bantamweight.
52, yeah. Sorry, let me double check.
Oh, sorry.
okay, 116. Gotcha. Okay, great. So I'm just, Yoshinari-san, does he have any interest in any other forms of kagutogi that he would ever like to try, maybe when he's older? Or if he has any interest in them now or is training in them?
あのこれから先でそのこれから先他のあのその格闘技に興味は格闘技にチャレンジするあの興味はありますか？
そうです。今のところはないですけど、あのボクシングだったり総合格闘技は見るのは好きなので、はい、興味はあります。
はい。He says no sort of real plans at the moment, but you know he loves watching MMA and boxing, so there's an interest, but I don't think there's anything concrete at this stage.
Well, you know, it's interesting that that both you and Inoue Naoya are both from Kanagawa, so you can maybe be the next boxer, big boxer from Kanagawa down the line. You can tell him that.
あのアンドリューからのコメントです。あの吉成選手はあの横須賀あの神奈川出身だと思うんですが、あのボクサーのあの井上尚弥選手もあの神奈川出身ですが、もしかして吉成選手も次のあの神奈川のボクサーとしてあの活躍されることもあるかもしれませんね。
もしかしたら。
He says maybe.
So Lisa, I think you also have some questions for Yoshinari-san, if you want to go ahead and ask him yourself.
Yep, sure. Shall we go with the Thai question? Maybe do you want to read that out in English?
Yeah, sure. And LJ, you asked, I understand he's been training and fighting in Thailand since grade school. What are some aspects of Thailand he likes or finds interesting outside of Muay Thai?
からの質問になりますが、あの小学校からそのタイでトレーニングや試合されていると思いますが、そのムエタイ以外であのタイの好きなとこもしくはタイの文化で興味深いと感じられることは何でしょうか？
タイのあの料理が僕すごい好きで、あのタイのなんだろうカオマンガイとかガパオとかすごい好きです。はい。
He says he loves Thai food like カオマンガイ and ガパオ。I think they're pretty popular Thai dishes. I think everyone loves Thai food.
Okay, I know what Pad Thai is. I don't know anything else though.
It's like a chicken sort of dish, I think.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Would he ever think about moving to Thailand permanently? Maybe bringing his team there or something along those lines?
Sure. あのタイにそのチームごと移住することとか考えられてますか？
は考えてないです。
He says no.
Okay. I think you also had another question about his music choices of music. I got the question right here. And you say he's a big fan of One OK Rock, and his walkout music is beginning. In particular, is an important song to him. Does he also listen to other music before a fight?
こちらもあの私から の, あの質問になります。吉成選手はあのワンオクロックのファンで、その入場曲でも使われているあのザ・ビギニングはあの吉成選手にとってあのその思い入れの強い一曲だというふうにお聞きしているんですが、その試合前とかもあのワンオクロックの曲など聞かれたりされますか？
はい、そうですね。あの自分は、いつからかな、まあ。中学生の頃ぐらいから聞いてて、すごい聞くとやる気が出るんで、試合前もいつも聞いてます。
はい。He says he's been listening to One Oak Rock since he was in about sort of junior high, and yes, he does listen to it before a fight to sort of elevate his mood.
Gotcha, gotcha. I'm curious to know what his thoughts. So it's interesting that kickboxing does have some relative notoriety in Japan, but for the most part in the West, with the exception of, I guess, Holland or wherever Gloria does her shows out
Glory.
Of. Yeah. But kickboxing never really took off in America or most of Europe. And I'm curious to know, does he think that kickboxing can it ever be a sport just as popular as MMA or as regular boxing outside Japan and the rest of the world?
そう、あのキックボクシングはその日本やあのオランダ以外では結構マイナースポーツだとというふうにあの認識があると思うんですが、吉成選手からしてそのこれからキックボクシングというスポーツは例えば普通あのプロボクシングやあの総合格闘技と同じようなあの認知度になると思いますか？
そうですね、やっぱりあのどんどん盛り上がるあのスターが一人いれば多分どんどん盛り上がっていくと思うので、そういうそのキックボクシングを象徴するような人物が一人いればどんどん盛り上がっていくと思います。
はい、He thinks that if there's a sort of a star sort of fighter in kickboxing, there is potential for it to grow in the future to, you know, the popularity of perhaps MMA or boxing.
Mm-hmm. And so what is he, I'm curious to know, outside of training, what does he like to do in his spare time?
Sure. 吉成選手はそのトレーニング以外のお時間でどういうふうにあの過ごす、あのお時間を過ごされていますか？
そうですね、あの友達と遊びに行ったりとか、家であのゆっくりテレビ見たりとかしてます。
はい、 He says I like to hang out with my friends and watch TV at home.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Any particular shows that he recommends on television and Japanese television that he's enjoying?
Sure. あの吉成選手のあの好きなあの番組は何でしょうか？
番組、好きな番組はそうですね、なんだろう、いろいろなんですけど、まあアメトークとか見ます。
はい、面白いですね、アメトーク。Andrew, he likes the show Ame Talk. I don't think people know, American viewers won't know it, but it's pretty good. It's very funny. Kind of like a talk show where they get a lot of comedians and they talk about a topic.
Oh, is it? Oh, okay. I feel like that's every Japanese comedy variety TV show. Is it saying like a Gaki no Sakai type?
No. It's sort of like sit down and then it's more tame than Gaki no Sakai.
Oh, okay. I gotcha. Okay.
Gaki no Sakai is like all over the place. You know, they do those crazy things.
But... Okay. Wakarimasu. I'm curious to know as well, after his fight in Ryzen 22, and I always, fighters always say that whenever they fight in Ryzen for the first time, they get a little bit more notoriety. Did that happen with him? Did he get like more followers on social media? Were people, I don't know, recognizing him on the street? I'm curious to know if he got any residual effect of having that fight in Ryzen, if he got some sort of more notoriety.
So, Ryzen 22 参戦後、あの周りの反響はあのいかがでしたでしょうか？あのやっぱりやはりあのそのフォロワーとかあの。
はい、
そのあの人に声をかけられることとか多くなりましたか？
そうですね、やっぱりあの SNS、インスタグラム、ツイッターのフォロワーはやっぱ増えましたし、あとはあの格闘技の会場とかでいるとあの声かけられたりすることが多くなったので、そういうところでやっぱり雷神の認知度はすごいなと思います。
He says that he did get an increase in his Instagram and Twitter followings. There's also he also tends to be approached more in various kakutogi events. You know, if he's there, people will approach him. And he says, oh, you know, that shows the sort of impact of Ryzen. It's like, you know, after getting into Ryzen, it's like it's made an impact in his life.
Mm-hmm. Now, I'm curious to know, this is a very common or popular trend among fighters in Japan. Does he eventually plan to make a YouTube channel?
あの格闘家の方があの結構 YouTube チャンネルを始められて YouTube チャンネルされている人が多いと思うんですが、吉成選手は今後 YouTube チャンネルをあの開設することはありますでしょうか？
今のところは考えてないですけど、まだ、はい、来年になったら、まあ、興味はあるので、まだちょっと考えてないですけど、はい、ちょっと興味あります。
He says, sort of no plans at this stage, but, you know, maybe he might change his mind. Like, he's interested, but, I mean, he doesn't have a plan, per se.
I got it. わかります。And so, with that, actually, we do have one important question I'm pretty sure that Luke would like us to ask. What is his favorite thing to order at Starbucks?
I think, sorry, you mean Trashy Drake fan.
Trashy right? Drake. They're going to be angry when I find out that I mix the two up. Okay. You can go ahead.
Yeah, I'll make the, yeah. Yoshi Nai 選手の大ファンの、トラッシュ、ハンドネームトラッシードレイクファンさん、フロリダの在住の、方からの、ご質問なんですが、まあ、大ファンであるにもかかわらず、彼が最も気になっているのは、吉内選手がスターバックスで何を普段オーダーされているかということ
です。普段はフラペチーノ頼みます。
はい、
抹茶の。
抹茶のフラペチーノですか。
はい。はい、
So, Trashy Drake fan, for your answer, that's a matcha frappuccino. You can write that down.
And I am very, very sorry, Trashy Drake. Gomenasai, I apologize for getting you two mixed up. I'm never going to hear the end of it properly. With that being said, Yoshinari-san, I do want to give you an opportunity to plug your sponsors, your SNS, your team, or anybody else you want to give a shout out to.
でこちらが番組 の, 最質問は終了いたしました。ここでその吉内選手 の, SNS の, ご紹介もしくはそのスポンサーやファンの皆様に何かコメントがありましたらお願いいたします。
はい、12月31日は自分がどんどんムエタイの技を出して会場を盛り上げるような試合をしたいと思ってますので、ツイッターやインスタグラムぜひチェックしてください。よろしくお願いします。
Hi. So Yoshinari-san says, so on the 31st of December, I want to be able to show my Muay Thai skills. So I hope you can watch my fight. I hope you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And I think maybe we can think we should introduce Yoshinari-san's Instagram page or and Twitter page. So I think, do you have the link, Andrew, perhaps?
Oh, not in front of me. If you give me a second.
Oh, that's all right. I've got it. Oh, okay. So his Twitter page, you can follow him at 445_NADA, 445_NADA. And his Instagram, I think we can post that on the sort of details of our YouTube video.
I'll be able to do that, yeah. And actually, I also want to know if he has any words for his opponent. I know he said something at the press conference, but I want to give him an opportunity to say anything that he wants to about his opponent. The floor is all his.
Sure, as if he was listening to this.
Yeah,
to this episode,
yeah.
Right? Yeah, yeah, sure. もし対戦相手の、すいません。もし対戦相手 のペットマライ選手がこのその、エピソードを見ていたとして何かコメントはありますでしょうか。
対戦相手のペットマライ選手もやっぱり日本の選手には負けられないっていう思いがあると思うんですけど、自分も、毎日練習してきて自信があるので試合は覚悟しておいてくださいっていう感じです。
He says, this is probably going to be a fight that Fat Mai can't really afford to lose, but, you know, he's also been training a lot, so he should basically, you know, just wait around and, you know, he'll see how strong Yoshinari-san is.
Yeah, and I apologize. Go inside. One more thing. I want to give him an opportunity to also just like, if he wants to say anything to his international fans, because I don't know if he does realize it, but he has many international fans as evidenced by the questions we got. So I want him to, you know, if he wants to say anything like thank you or whatever he wants to say to his fans outside of Japan as well.
Sure. 吉内選手がご存知であるかどうか分かりませんが、その吉内選手のファンは海外でたくさんいらっしゃいますので、その海外のファンに向けて何かコメントをお願いできますでしょうか。
はい、海外からのそういうファンが見て自分も本当に嬉しいですし、これからもどんどん強くなって見てる人が楽しんでもらえるような試合をしたいと思っているので、 これからもぜひ応援してください。
So Yoshinari-san's message to his international fans. I'm really happy to hear that I have a lot of overseas fans, and I'm going to continue to get stronger. I'll be able to show you, you know, my continued progress in these fights. And I thank you very much for your support.
And you can see Yoshinari-san fight at Ryzen 26 New Year's Eve at the famous Saitama Super Arena. He'll be taking on Fett Molly in a kickboxing match with elbows, and it's gonna be an exciting fight, just like his first fight was. And it, you know, I'm looking forward to it. I know you are, LJ, and I know a lot of fans are. And so, with that being said, Yoshinari-san, we really appreciate your time. Good luck in your fight, and we hope that we can talk to you again, because I think you're only gonna go up from here. Yeah, feel free to tell him that.
Yep, sure. あの、本日あの、お忙しい中ご出演していただき誠にありがとうございました。吉内選手の、あの、ご健勝と、あの、ご多幸を願っております。あの、これから、あの、吉内選手は、あの、どんどん、あの、そのスター、さらなる、あの、スター選手になっていくと思いますので、あの、また、あの、私どもの、あの、番組に、あの、ご出演していただければと思っております。
はい、ぜひお願いします。
He says, thank you, absolutely.
And with that being said, we wish you best of luck. Ganbare desu.
ありがとうございます。
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 ありがとうございます。